Hi everyone. Today I'm back with an ancient column about, it was about August 1980, and it's called Oh the Pain. This is going to hurt me more than it is you. I heard that all my life. As a child, I doubted the statement's accuracy. Yeah, Mom, sure it is. I also knew I was in for some kind of painful jolt after those words were spoken. Now, as a mother, I can say, I'm sorry, Mom, for all doubting your words. I feel the same pain today. For the past week, I've been hurting for my son. No, Robbie hasn't been in pain for an entire week. He hasn't because he hasn't known what his all-knowing mother knows. I know he soon will be taken away by a relative stranger, put to the test, while his mother stands by in another room, wringing her hands, helpless. My five-year-old firstborn, my darling little son, Robbie, is heading to the dentist for the treatment of his first cavity. That man in the white smock assured me last week that my baby boy would be fine. He said he would explain everything to Robbie, and it was the best not to upset my little boy by telling him beforehand about the SHOT. I gasped, the shot. My God, he's going to have a shot. After a strong whiff of smelling small salts, I agreed to let the expert handle everything. I told my intelligent side, the dentist worked on children every day, that he came highly recommended, and it was all for Robbie's good health. To my emotional side, I kept crying inwardly, my poor baby, my poor baby. All week long, I watched Robbie playing innocently, unaware of what he would soon face. He was confident his wonderful mother would never intentionally do anything to hurt him and that she was always looking out for his happiness. If he only knew. But soon he would know what life is all about. Life is about pain for health's sake. Life is a mother who makes her beloved son experience the wrath of a dental drill, and life is Mom hurting along with him. For my own mental health, I kept repeating, it's for his own good. It's for his own good. It won't last long. It's only a little cavity. The words are supposed to come from me. Then why, as I take his hand and head to the dentist's office, do I feel like I'm leading the lamb to the slaughter? By the way, Robbie did great, not a tear. I believe my reaction to the dentist had something to do with the dentist of my youth. The pain was expected and experienced back in the day. Today, dentists are so much better at easing a patient through dental work. Oh, you fell asleep. That is so nice, Kari. So, I was excited about Robbie's first cavity. And it made me nervous and upset me a lot more than it did him. 1981. I hope you enjoy my stories. Have a good day.